Oil pulling. You take a little bit of oil, you swish it around in your mouth, and you pretty much live forever. That's pretty much what the internet is telling us, and I wanted to do this video to explain a little bit more about the science of oil pulling and how it actually works, because there's so many different testimonials out there on the internet that I just think it's just confusing, and so many people have asked me about it. So first off, what is oil pulling? All right, what it is you take like a teaspoon to a tablespoon of oil, usually like a sesame oil or a vitamin E kind of oil. You swish it around in your mouth for a while until it turns to like a milky white consistency. Then you spit it out. You swish some water around your mouth, clean it out, and then ideally you're supposed to brush your teeth afterwards. Okay, you're doing this usually in a fasted state. You're supposed to do it first thing in the morning before you eat anything. And it's supposed to do a couple things. The oil is supposed to start stimulating a digestive process that occurs when your mouth senses some calories and the body starts producing some digestive enzymes and stuff like that. The other side is you're supposed to start an enzymatic process just overall in the blood where the oil actually pulls bacteria and toxins out of the blood. So in theory, it makes sense. But you all know me, and I'm a research nerd, and I wanted to dive in and find a little bit more about it. So here's my issue with oil pulling and why I have some kind of reservations as to whether or not it really works for overall detoxification. You see, the actual mucosal layer, that mucosal lining, that membrane in our mouth is not semi-permeable. What that means is that toxins and bacteria shouldn't be able to permeate that membrane to get into the mouth for the oil to be able to actually have that positive effect. So that's where my issue lies with it. However, from the side of generating an enzymatic response, that's still inconclusive. I don't know, that could still be the case. However, oral health is a completely different story. And I know that most of the people watching this video might not be super interested in the overall oral health benefits, but it does kind of lead me to believe that further on down the line, sure, maybe some of these detoxification effects could actually apply. There was one study in particular that was done in 2008 that took adolescent males, and they were trying to fight basically a plaque that's known as S. mutans. That S. mutans is one of the main bacteria in our mouth. It's the main bacteria that causes tooth decay, cavities, things like that. It's really the most well-known one. They took two groups of adolescents. One group, they gave chlorhexidine, which is basically a kind of mouthwash, and another group, they did an oil pulling technique. Well, what's interesting is the effect on the S. mutans was about the same. This seems to show us that we have a pretty positive effect on overall bacteria reduction from the oil in our mouth, but we just don't know if it's actually pulling it from the bloodstream through the membrane and actually detoxing the body in the process. But the oral benefits seem to be pretty darn strong. But there are a couple simple theories as to why it might work with mouth bacteria and why it may not work with the body. You see, the first theory is simply that maybe the oil that you're swishing around in the mouth, that higher viscosity of the oil makes it harder for the bacteria to adhere within the oral cavity, makes it harder for it to adhere to the teeth and the gums and stuff like that. So therefore the bacteria is just not sticking there, which if you think about that, that could mean that you're washing that bacteria down into your gut, which could be bad. I'm not saying oil pulling is bad. I am just kind of going off here thinking on my own terms that that could potentially cause an issue. Now, the other thing that's interesting is when you swish oil around your mouth, you create a little bit of an alkali hydrolysis effect. What that kind of means is that you're swishing oil around to the point where it actually changes structure and becomes literally somewhat of a soap. Like if you've ever made soap before, sometimes you need those tannins, you need those fats to actually create a soap. So you're kind of creating a soap in your mouth, which could be killing off some of the bacteria in your mouth as well. So all the research studies that are showing we have an impact on mouth bacteria could be added up simply by the fact that there are these actual theories that make sense there, but not applying to the human body as a whole. Lastly, we have to remember that standard oil pulling techniques recommend the use of sesame oil or vitamin E oil. Sesame oil is high in vitamin E, which is a powerful antioxidant oil to begin with, which means that we could just be reducing free radicals in our mouth as is. Now, we may have a small trickle effect that trickles down into the body, but if we're reducing free radicals in the mouth, we're gonna have less bacteria. We're gonna have less oxidative effect, oxidative waste. So there you have it. I'm not an expert on oil pulling, but there have been enough questions that prompted me to at least do this video and explain it a little bit more. So at the end of the day, sure, I'll do it. I'll do it for the health benefits of my mouth. I'll do it. It's always good to take care of your oral cavity, but I'm definitely not going to jump to conclusions and think that it's going to purify my body and absolutely detoxify my blood the way that an anti-inflammatory diet would. As always, keep it locked in here in my videos. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions for a new video, just post them on below and I will definitely take them into consideration. Take it easy. See you in the next video.